17 News is your local election headquarters. If you are a registered voter in Kern County, you may have already received your mail-in ballot. We are now just 1 month away from California's March 5th primary election. 17's Jenny Hutt joins us now to explain what you need to know if you want to vote by mail or not. Jenny?
Tammy, just 29 days until California voters cast their first round of votes in the 2024 presidential election cycle. Some received their mail-in ballots late last week and have already dropped off their ballots. Others can expect them this week.
These winter storms may bring some soggy mail to your doorsteps, but keep an eye out for this, your official mail-in ballot.
So if voters haven't received their vote by mail ballots by Friday, February 9th, then they should contact our office either to have a ballot reissued.
Ahead of the March 5th primary election, registered voters should have received or will receive three key pieces of mail. A voter information guide from the Secretary of State, one per household, as well as a sample ballot and mail-in ballot from Kern Elections, one of each per registered voter. The mail-in ballot lets you vote by mail, which Kern Auditor Controller County Clerk Amy Espinoza says lets voters vote a little early and take their time.
It's taking it out of the sending envelope and voting your ballot normally. There are instructions for every race. There are instructions for the entire ballot, how to mark your ballot. So they can either drop it in the mailbox or they can find an official Kern County drop box.
County drop boxes are now open. There are 19 total, including on Bakersfield College and Cal State Bakersfield campuses. Each has security cameras. You can mail back your ballots as soon as they're filled out. Ballots with invalid or missing signatures will not be counted. Espinoza says look out for a cure letter.
So that notifies the voter that either their signature did not match or they were missing a signature, and it gives them an opportunity to cure that, to correct it, to sign again and send it back to our office.
Because this is a presidential election, voters will get party-specific ballots for the primary. If you're not registered with a party, you have two options, register or request a crossover ballot.
There are some parties that allow non-party preference to vote in their primary, and so they've been notified by mail.
Espinoza says Kern Elections could start processing ballots as early as this week.
Reminding people you don't have to vote for every single race. The races that you do vote for will still count.
Again, you must sign your ballots, and that signature has to match what is on file at Kern Elections. To vote for a write-in candidate, mark that bubble and manually write in that candidate's name. The list of candidates is still being finalized. And you can sign up to track your ballot from when it's mailed to you to when it's counted. For more information on voting by mail and in person, go to our website, kget.com. Jenny Hupp, 17 News.
All right, thanks, Jenny. And